Hey, what's going on, man?
What up, bro?
Just picked up this brand new laptop, the MSI GL62, and we're gonna... Fuck.
Bro.
We were gonna do an unboxing of it, but... Somebody won't tell me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the
sharpest tool in the shed. Yo, what's going on, Xbox and YouTube? And as you can tell from the beginning of the video, we are doing an unboxing of a brand new laptop, the MSI GL62. Now, this is a laptop I picked up a couple weeks ago, and I have been using it to live stream ever since, pretty much running it through its paces, and this laptop is an absolute monster. So, we are going to run through all of the features of the laptop and basically compare it to what I used to have, which was a complete garbage mess, so it's not going to be much to compare to. But what's really cool about this laptop, at least my favorite thing, is it runs the NVIDIA GeForce GTX series, which uses the brand new Pascal architecture, which is 15% faster than a 965M if you have the 1050 Ti edition, and 30% faster than a 960M if you have the 1050 edition. Now, this laptop is the 1050 edition, so it is 30% faster than a 960M, which is pretty amazing, and it just makes for an overall gnarly gaming experience on a laptop. Now, this laptop is fairly cheap, coming in at just under $1,000, but for all of the features and the minor gaming that you can do on it, I'm not saying major gaming, but you can get some games running pretty good at like 30 frames a second. But it's more or less a editing workhorse and a live streaming workhorse, at least in my opinion. But it also comes with a PCI Express Gen 3 SSD, which can transfer data at over 2,000 megabytes a second. Also, Cooler Boost 4, which is like kind of just their own way of saying it has a really nice heatsink with up to 6 heat pipes in it, a fan boost key, which is right on the front of the laptop itself, dual fans and dual thermal solutions. It also comes with 8 gigs of DDR4 RAM, which I do believe is expandable up to 32 gigs, but realistically, who the hell needs that? We also have virtual surround sound, which gives you 360 virtual surround sound, which gives it a little bit of a better feel for first-person shooters, and it gives you a little bit more of an awareness, which I guess is kind of cool, I guess, depending on who you are. It also comes with audio boost and hi-fi sound, which is not really my favorite thing at all. I wouldn't even call that a feature. It also comes with the SteelSeries keyboard, which once again, I would not even call a feature. This keyboard is absolutely horrible compared to other keyboards I've seen on laptops. But for the price point, I'm really not going to complain about the non-illuminated keys and the fact that the keys just feel really cheap and susceptible to sticking. It also supports multiple displays at 4K 60Hz, which is quite surprising, with a DisplayPort Mini and an HDMI out on it. It also has Shift in it, which is some sort of dynamic performance balancing, which I don't honestly see why anyone would ever want to use this unless you are using your laptop on your battery. It also takes full control of the Dragon Center, which basically takes control of all of the aspects of your laptop from your microphone to your webcam. Just makes it a little bit easier when setting all of that up. We also have XBoost, which boosts your USB storage and your USB speeds up to 10% for storage speed and up to 30% for a USB transfer, which isn't too bad. And for the final feature, we have USB Type-C 3.0, and we have 3 USB 3.1 jacks. Now, personally, I would have rathered 4 USB 3.1 jacks, and you could have just kept your USB Type-C adapter or jack, because now I have to use an adapter in order to get my 4th USB. But overall, guys, this laptop is really good, and for the price point of just under $1,000 and a full 1080p, I believe a 17-inch or 15-inch screen. Also, it is ran by Intel, not AMD, so that is just a world of a difference in my opinion. And we don't have AMD GPUs in this, we have the brand new GTX series. So these are all things to really take into account when you are looking for a laptop. In my opinion, don't go AMD, always go Intel, always go NVIDIA. But if I were to rate this laptop out of 10, I would give it a solid 7 out of 10 for some of the features that it lacks, such as an illuminable keyboard and a 1080p webcam, and maybe just a slightly bigger hard drive, because this only comes with a 256 gigabyte hard drive. Mind you, you can expand it, but that is just something else you'll have to buy in the future. So overall, I really do enjoy this laptop, and like I said, if I were to rate it, I would give it a solid 7 out of 10, and I would give it a solid 10 out of 10 as far as a live streaming machine goes, and as far as gaming, we can give it a nice 5, because gaming is kind of its low point, at least in my opinion. But if I've opened your guys' perspective on the brand new MSI 7th Gen Series GL62, please remember to like, subscribe, and comment, and we will see you guys on the next one. Peace.